It would be Yeezy to say that Christmas came early this year because of all the Yeezy releases that we've been getting. And sometimes it's just like, yay, chill. You know, there's so many dropping, we don't have enough time to buy all of them.
I'm sorry,
I couldn't resist. In all seriousness though, today I'm reviewing a pair of Yeezys that I've been excited about and looking forward to ever since they were first leaked a couple months back. What's up everybody, I'm Seth Fowler, and today I'm reviewing the upcoming Adidas Yeezy Boost 350 V2 Beluga Reflective. I'm so stoked that Adidas is re-releasing, at least in a way, one of my favorite Yeezy 350 V2s of all time. I love this colorway. This is like the classic 350 V2. And yes, I guess technically it is a little bit different from the original release, but it's a great looking pair of sneakers and I am so stoked to finally have them. So if you're trying to grab a pair of the upcoming Adidas Yeezy Boost 350 V2 Beluga Reflectives, they drop on December 18th in the United States for a retail price of $220. And I don't know anything personally about stock numbers of this shoe, but I have heard through the grapevine and also because of the fact that resale prices of this shoe currently are pretty low in comparison to most other early pairs of Yeezys, that this shoe could be pretty widely available. I have no idea how widely available. I have no idea if this is going to be the most mass-produced pair of 350s ever, or maybe all the rumors are false. I have no clue. But based on sort of what I've been seeing and what I've been hearing, I would like to think that this shoe will be one of the most available pairs of 350 V2s. But before we dive into the sneaker itself, let's take a quick look at the retail packaging. So this pair of 350 V2s comes in the standard 350 V2 box. It features your natural cardboard finish and of course 350 printed across the top. It's kind of interesting to see Yeezy go back to the standard 350 box from the Yeezy 350 V2 compact box that we just looked at in the last review, which by the way, if you haven't seen my review of the 350 V2 compacts, I definitely recommend checking it out by clicking the link at the top of the screen. Honestly, this is becoming one of my favorite sneakers of 2021. I did not think I was gonna like it because I don't love it visually, but after wearing the shoe for a couple days, I'm in love. But getting back into the box, you've got Boost printed on one side. It is also a drawer box, so you can open it like this. And you've got Yeezy Boost 350 and Made by Adidas printed on the outside of the drawer. Then on the other side of the box, you've got the size tag and the official colorway is Beluga Reflective Gray Solar Red. But now with the box out of the way, let's take a closer look at the Reflective Belugas. So I've definitely been a fan of Kanye and Adidas re-releasing popular 350 V2 colorways. And I really wish they'd released some of the popular 350 V1 colorways. I mean, I guess they sort of did with the Pirate Blacks, but I would really like some V1s in 2022. I know that's not gonna happen, but that would be cool to see. And although I like Adidas re-releasing some of the popular colorways in almost a one-to-one version, I also like them trying something a little bit different and slightly changing up the shoe. And in my opinion, making a reflective version of a classic colorway is a really great way to do that. Man, this is crazy. I couldn't get a pair of Beluga 1.0s to review back in 2016 when they first released, and so I never got a chance to really review the sneaker, but now, what, 5 years later, I have a chance to give you guys a full-on, real Beluga 1.0 review, and it feels like I'm holding the original shoe from 2016. This is crazy. So starting off in this pair of 350s, the upper of the shoe comes in your classic 350 V2 Prime Knit upper. As you can tell, the Prime Knit is a mix of a couple different colors. You've got sort of a medium gray, a darker gray, and then you've also got some speckles of orange woven throughout. And in my opinion, this is the most iconic 350 V2 pattern. You've got these zebra stripes along the medial side of the shoe that really give the sneaker a very cool sort of wavy linear look, which I love. And I also really love the little speckles of orange throughout the upper. They really seem to give the shoe a little bit more dimension and depth. Then running down the lateral side of the shoe, from pretty much the heel all the way to the toe, you've got your classic double Yeezy stripes. And while yes, 5 years later, we do still have a version of this stripe, usually in semi-translucent plastic form, it just never seems as iconic or as eye-catching as the original Beluga stripe. This bright neon orange stripe, while polarizing when the shoe first released, has become one of the most memorable Yeezy details I think we've ever seen on any Adidas Yeezy. Also, can I just say how nice the orange side stripe on the shoe looks next to the brand new Apothecary Graffiti collection in orange? Looks incredible. I love the way the shoe looks on foot, and I will definitely be wearing this pair of socks with this pair of shoes. Just below the bright orange stripe, you've got this flat, simple gray stripe, which I really feel like helps add some contrast to the side of the shoe. It helps the orange stripe stand out even more because it sort of fights for attention when you see it against the linear upper, but when you put it against this sort of simple gray stripe, it really helps it pop. Of course, on the toe and on the heel of the shoe, the stripes sort of pixelate out into nothingness, which I absolutely love. I wish they still did that. And I also like the fact that the stripes actually go all the way to the toe of the sneaker and all the way to the heel. Unfortunately, they don't really do that anymore. They sort of end like half an inch from the seam that runs down the center of the shoe. I know it's not a huge deal, but for me, I just love it. I love the fact that it really makes the entire lateral side of the shoe have some interest and some detail on it. Of course, on the midfoot of the shoe, in the center of this orange stripe, you've got your classic SPLY 350 text in light gray. And unlike some of the newer 350 V2s where the text is actually mirrored from one shoe to the other, where one side is legible and the other side is backwards, on the Belugas, they both read correctly. On the right shoe, the SPLY comes from the back of the sneaker, and on the left shoe, it comes from the front of the sneaker. I've always wondered why they changed that and why they mirrored it. Maybe it's easier for production, maybe it's a design choice. I have no idea why, but it's kind of nice to see the OG look on this sneaker. Now, obviously, I failed to mention one of the most important details on the Beluga reflectives, and that's the reflective thread woven throughout the upper of the shoe. Now, as you've probably noticed, or not noticed in this case, it's actually pretty difficult to see the reflective thread when this shoe is just in standard lighting. In fact, this shoe actually seems a lot less reflective than really any of the other reflective 350 V2s, and I'm not sure exactly why that is. It's possible that because the shoe has been out for a while, and the shoe's been made thousands and thousands and thousands of times, they didn't want to change up the manufacturing process too much, and so instead of just completely redesigning the upper of the shoe, they decided to just kind of like slip in a couple of reflective threads here and there. That's kind of what it seems like, but honestly, I have no idea, and really, I'm just happy to have a pair of Belugas. But it is nice that there is some reflective thread in there, especially because this is a reflective 350 V2. They're just harder to see unless you take a picture of this shoe at night with the flash. And I've got to say, when you do actually take a picture of this shoe with the flash, the reflective threads do come through really nicely. They sort of sprinkle throughout the upper of the shoe. It's not like they're concentrated in one place. They did a good job of keeping everything pretty even, and I like the fact that it's relatively subtle. It actually took me a couple times taking pictures of the shoe to even find the reflective threads. It's honestly a nice subtle way of differentiating the different releases of this shoe from one another without overdoing it and making the shoe look completely different. Running down the center of the shoe, you've got that classic stitch detail that holds the two different sides of the sneaker together. I've always liked that detail. It kind of gives the shoe a handmade quality, which is pretty cool on such a futuristic looking sneaker. Then weaving through the upper of the shoe, you've got these thick rope laces that come in gray and darker gray. From what I could tell, the rope laces don't actually have any reflective details, and the reflective details on the shoe seem to be specifically only on the primeknit upper portion. It's actually kind of odd that they didn't use reflective laces on this shoe, but no big deal, I don't mind it. Then moving up to the top of the sneaker, around the top of the ankle opening, you've got this light gray piping, and moving inside the sneaker, you've got your pretty standard Yeezy sock liner. The sock liner comes in light gray and is really only around the back half of the shoe. It's also pretty well padded, and of course it features the Adidas Three Stripes branding sort of pressed onto the back of the heel. The insole of the sneaker is your standard Yeezy Boost 350 V2 insole. It comes in light gray and features the Adidas and Yeezy branding printed on the heel in dark gray. Now, getting into fit, there are a lot of things I love about this shoe, and I love the fact that this shoe is a pretty much one-to-one remake of the original Belugas. But there are some downsides because this shoe is a one-to-one remake of the original Belugas, and that's that this shoe does not fit true to size. I love the fact that the new 350 V2 compacts fit true to size and they fit incredibly well, but unfortunately in original 350 V2s, it's really a good idea to go up half a size because they always seem to fit a little bit tight if you don't. And from what I can tell, the new Beluga reflectives fit just like the originals and fit pretty much like every other pair of 350 V2s, so if you're grabbing this shoe, in my opinion, you should go up half a size. But of course, if you have the chance to try on this pair of 350 V2s or really any other pair of 350 V2s before you buy this one, I definitely recommend doing that to make sure that you grab the right size for you. Continuing around to the back of the shoe, you'll notice that this pair of 350 V2s does not have a heel pull tab because, of course, the original Belugas didn't either. It does still have this stitch detail that you found on the front of the shoe running down the center of the heel, and of course, these two stripes carry on all the way around to the back of the shoe and start pixelating into nothing on the medial side of the sneaker. I also really like how they kept this little butt detail at the back of the shoe. That was something that people used to use to legit check Yeezy sneakers because fakes didn't have this little butt before the top of the midsole, and it's kind of nice to see that they kept it. They could have gotten rid of it, but they kept it. It's just kind of a funny little quirk on the back of the shoe, and I love it. Then moving down on the shoe, you get to your classic, iconic, semi-translucent, smoke gray Yeezy ribbed midsole. I love the way that this midsole looks. It looks amazing. It's the iconic Yeezy midsole. I also love the fact that the rubber that they used on the outsole of the shoe is pretty much the same exact tone as the rubber that they used in the midsole, because of course that rubber wraps up onto the back of the shoe. And on some colorways, it kind of looks like the shoe had an accident. But I like the fact that they kept the color of the rubber pretty much the same all the way throughout, so it stays consistent and it blends in nicely. Of course, because this is a Yeezy Boost, this shoe features a full-length Boost midsole, which feels incredible underfoot. I absolutely love it. And then rounding off the bottom of the sneaker, you've got the semi-translucent smoke gray rubber outsole. Overall, I love this shoe. I'm so happy that Adidas and Yeezy decided to re-release one of their most iconic sneakers of all time. This is one of those colorways that everyone wanted to restock, and it just never restocked. And the fact that Adidas decided to change it up ever so slightly and add that reflective detail actually makes the shoe even more interesting because I love reflective details. However, as far as construction, this shoe is pretty much the exact same shoe that released back in 2016, meaning that the fit isn't exactly perfect, the overall comfort isn't as nice as something like the 350 V2 Compacts. It's still a great shoe overall, but don't expect it to be really any different than any other pair of 350 V2s as far as comfort and fit. But now I would love to know your thoughts on the Beluga Reflectives and whether you plan to grab a pair when these finally release on December 18th. So make sure to let me know in the comment section down below. And as always, thank you so much for watching. Make sure to subscribe if you haven't yet, and I'll see you all in the next one.